Hello everyone, my name is Christopher Nightingale.
I am Joseph Pickles, and this is our sometimes misunderstood friend, that is Stephen Sargent.
Why are we here? What's life all about? Is God really real? Or is there some doubt? Well, tonight we're going to sort it all out. For tonight, it's the meaning of life.
So, Sarge, I mean, we've talked a lot about teachers. If you were a teacher, how would you teach a class?
What would your style be? What subject would you choose to teach?
PE.
Okay, and how would you teach him?
Just kick a football about for an hour.
No, it's got to be more structured than that, because you have things, you have objectives you have to achieve, goals you have to get to over the year. You can't just give him a football and say, do it.
Yeah, you can.
You can't. And also, that's not the only sport.
You can't. I mean, sure enough, in games, that's what you do.
Yeah.
But that's games in order to practice the PE.
You're going to be fucked when Ofsted come
round. I'm wondering if he'd pass his CRB. I mean, he might even get a first CRB. So you're done with it already.
No. Yeah, games, because it's easy. Did you ever see any of the games teachers do? All what they did was, here's a football, here's a rugby ball, play rugby. The name of the game is to score as more tries as them. Don't knock them out. Don't take their head off. Don't break any limbs. And we'll just wander around and watch it.
No, sorry, this is the whole point, right? There's no just games teacher, right? They are PE teachers who teach both PE and games. They teach the actual PE in the PE sessions, and then it's put into practice in games.
Actually, when we did circuit training, we had to learn about the cardiovascular system.
There you are.
Right, so
that was like a 20-second job, though. You just said, this is because if you do all this, and that, you'll be all right.
And that provides your lessons with structure.
If you're he goes, like, just run around, punch a punch bag, and run up and down this line.
If you're a PE teacher, you have a sheet, right? A piece of paper, and it says you have to do this, right? So in February, it may say you have to teach them gymnastics before the end of the term, right? You have to do that whether you like it or not.
Don't like gymnastics.
Well, you're going to have to do it.
It's on the piece of paper.
Said you have to do it, so you know, you have to do it. So tell me how you do it.
I'll tell her to fuck off because I don't like gymnastics.
You don't have a job anymore. See you, Sarge.
No, it would be the sport I like. February, it won't be gymnastics.
That's the government's decision, lad. It's not
ice hockey. I've been watching that at the Olympics, and that is brutal. Ice hockey is brilliant.
Brilliant. So you're going to teach them ice hockey when we have no ice rinks at all within, what, about 30 miles?
No.
Well, year three is year four. We already like to kick the shit out of each other.
No, I thought this is secondary school teacher.
Okay, how to kick the shit out of each other with hockey sticks in ice hockey. Well, yeah.
No, I thought this was secondary school teaching, not primary school.
Could be anything.
Okay, yeah, secondary school teaching. Yeah. But then, how many secondary school pupils actually know how to skate?
It wouldn't be.
Do you know how to skate?
Do you know how to skate?
Yeah.
Do you know how to do ice skating?
Yeah.
You actually do know how to a competent enough level to teach.
We would get roller skates, right? We'll get roller skates and ice hockey and sticks and just play with a puck.
No, right.
So that's normal hockey then.
Right.
Yeah,
imagine.
No, there isn't such thing as hockey on roller. I have never heard that in my life. Rollerblading hockey.
Yeah.
But the thing is,
does that even exist?
No, but I've painted it though. That's my idea, so you can't fucking nick this, people.
You can't look at the camera!
No one will nick this, folks. It's on the worst idea I've ever heard.
It's a great idea.
No, it's not!
Right, so there's an ice rink. So there's an ice rink, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know what school has the money to get their own ice rink, but apparently they do. Right, and there's you, and there's like 25 kids. You can't skate on ice. You've just told us you can't really skate on ice without falling over. Right, and you have to teach them how to ice skate and play hockey on ice.
I'll
right?
delegate because Stuart Van Ark is brilliant at ice skating.
One kid, and he's not even a kid anymore.
No, but I'll get him back to show him how to ice skate.
He might be busy in like New Zealand or yeah. He's in Chile. Halfway up a mountain.
Travelling, I think? So, you can't have him.
I mean, it's a stupid idea anyway. You don't do ice skating in high school.
Maybe not.
Okay. And the whole point is, Sarge, that you give them a set of things to do.
Hockey, you can do hockey.
I only got one chance to play hockey, and then Mrs. Pearson
was
shot for.
Well, are you sure it wasn't because you
play
tried,
it anymore?
Are you sure it wasn't because you tried to kick the shit out of the other kids with the hockey stick? I mean, I wouldn't stop you playing it.
No, I actually took it seriously. And then we played rounders and all sorts
of stuff. Yeah, but you take football seriously, and well, that's. Yeah. Not said. So
No, we played rounders and I tried taking that seriously enough and I don't know the rule properly. Do you drop the bat or take it with you? So I decided to do the opposite of what I was told.
Rounders.
And, yeah, she sent me out, so I told her to fuck off and I got sent back in ILC for the rest of the day.
Of course you got like sent off because like you basically told a PE teacher how to do like the rule of a sport that didn't exist.
And they told him to fuck off.
Yeah. So you basically misinterpreted the rules, then told her off for you getting it wrong, and then got chucked out.
Yeah.
Genius.
Yeah.
I mean, she wasn't the greatest of teachers, but I mean, you understand.
I think it was a taller one with the bar.
Oh, so it wasn't even.
I don't know who it was.
Anyway, so we're talking about you being a teacher.
Yeah.
So, right, firstly, you won't pass the RB, but we'll overlook that on this occasion.
Okay. Yeah, I will.
Ofsted.
Because I'm not a pedo.
What are you going to do on Ofsted come and they say, we want you to teach in a certain sport and you don't like that sport? You've still got to
do it.
Ofsted.
You can't just tell the head teacher.
Well, what's the sport
off
then? Well, what's the sport like, Mr. Ofsted person? What's the sport?
Okay, netball.
Netball? I don't even know the rules in netball.
Yes, but you've got to learn.
You've just chosen. I mean, if you want to, you can be a different teacher. But you said to us you want to be a PE teacher.
Right on my
netball
hand.
Is
netball.
That's ultimate professionalism. That is
fucking genius.
A wing forward, a goalkeeper, a wing defender, or whatever the.
How many? I don't even know how many players are on netball.
Nine, isn't there?
Seven.
Google it.
Ben's not here, Sarge.
If you do them, yeah. No, I presume it's nine.
Yeah. I don't know.
So you wouldn't? You'd be scuffed then.
I'd delegate. I'd just pull a sickie when Ofsted are in.
Yeah, but you're the only PE teacher in a struggling school with financial difficulties.
Brilliant.
And you want to take the day off.
Yeah.
That is brilliant. That is absolutely brilliant. And what happens when you come in the next day and you've made a miraculous recovery and then they check with, oh, have you been to the doctor for a sick note? Oh,
yeah.
Sorry, no, I'm not actually ill. Oh, that's going to look great, isn't it?
No, because I know someone who is a doctor and he can forge me one.
Well, okay. Well, no, it can't.
So now,
you want to
Ofsted
teach
a week. So you just book, you just say, the shit
so you have
the week off.
You wanted to teach ice hockey when you got allowed.
Yeah.
You told teachers to fuck off. You failed CLB and now committed fraud by forging doctor notes. So you're actually probably in some kind of courtroom somewhere.
Basically, don't go into teaching. For the love of God.
Yeah.
I told you this, don't go as a teacher. Okay, right.
Yeah,
right.
But we asked you. We asked you, and
it just ended in you in court. So let's move on to.
Let's move on to something else.
So we've talked about high school, and of course Ripley St Thomas has become an academy now since we left. It's no longer a high school. What do you think the difference is? Because I honestly don't know, and that, I don't think Pickles was
between high schools and academies. What do you think?
What's
I think I know what it might be. But
money.
Oh, well, he's there.
That's what I think. You actually got a question right.
Yeah! Yes! Go Kingerton!
It's a first!
And we've been through the fact that if you're a teacher, how would you run the place? So if you were head of Ripley St. Thomas Academy, what would you change? Would you change anything?
I mean, would you
run it the same as when you were there?
Obviously, you say it's down to funding. So academies... Personally, I don't agree with them, but you know, that's a different story. They get money based on targets they hit. So if you can't get any funding, you have to hit the targets that you've been set. So you can't just have a piss around and go to one tower every day.
Oh dear.
So you're going to have to actually do stuff. And it probably doesn't involve ice skating. So how would you run the academy?
What would you change?
Because it's all run on statistics, isn't it?
Explain,
you're quite clever, so you can be the dumb fuck. Right, if you were the smart one, right, you would get, be expected to get A stars, right? So you would get you'd be the one who would go on the list of greatness. Sorry, Chris, you wouldn't.
The list of greatness?
Yeah, like, you would be the one who is responsible for getting the school funding, so you would be in, like, the topper set because you're going to get the better grades.
So
you're going to be the one who plays on the laptops every Wednesday with Mrs. Tag. She knows what else great at. That's why I did it. And, so, yeah.
Carry on.
Yeah, so you would... I don't even know what the fuck I'm saying now.
I actually don't know what you're saying. I don't even know. I mean, sorry. All I know is I'm a clever one and I teach the
right.
dumb one.
Okay. From what I've gathered so far, what you said is what schools already do, putting clever people into the top set.
That's what happens already.
Well, no, sorry, what was it? The list of greatness?
Yeah, the list of greatness.
Yeah. Please expand on the list of greatness.
What is the list of greatness?
That's a new one for
me. It's like, if you get straight A stars, that is pretty great.
Okay,
so you'd go on the list of A stars achieved.
So greatness.
So on your desk, in the main office, you would have your phone and, you know, your kettle in the corner, and then you have your list of greatness, and then with loads of names on it.
Yeah, no, but if there's a guy,
that's not favouritism at all.
No, if there was a guy on it who was really clever but also a bit of a knobhead, he wouldn't go on that list. He would go on another list.
So you're gonna judge and select your kids based on whether you like them or not.
But it's based on targets, Sarge. It's not based on personalities.
Can we cut this and just start this question again?
This is the kind of answer we want. Because we don't want the perfect answer from every time, because that's boring. It's going to be like, yes.
No, but I've lost what I was saying. I don't even know what I was saying now.
You never did at the start.
No, you never did.
So, I think it's fucking stupid.
Right, so basically, right, I've got a picture of your desk in your office, right? That's me. I'm telling you to fuck off, right? Because it's a shit school. Alright, you've got your little phone there.
Yeah.
You've got your order from the police from having to cut a hole in the fence.
Oh, you've missed out the pile of like resignation notices from all the teachers.
I've got them as well, right?
Yeah, because they'll want to leave on your appointment.
I've got your list of greatness.
Are you going to have to show this to
the right? And then I've got your little notes from the teacher saying all the things. And then I've got one note in the middle saying, get Layley back. Fucking hell, bring Layley back with you, fucking as their teacher. Because this is shite.
Really. God damn it. I mean...
I'd bring him back anyway. He was an awesome teacher, better than that.
He's retired. Let the man enjoy himself. You can't bring him back.
Yeah, I just don't know what I'd do if I was a teacher. It's best not to change. Why? If it's broken, don't fix it.
Wait. No, that's wrong. If it's broken, do fix it.
If it's broken, fix it.
If it's not broken, don't fix it.
Oh, goodness.
And if it isn't broken, don't fuck with it.
That was genius.
Yeah.
Oh, that was great. That
right,
was.
Okay, so you've been sacked as a teacher, and you've also been sacked as the head of the
school
at the Cameron. But for some random ass reason,
Knobhead Cameron.
Cameron decides to give you the education post, Michael Gove's position.
Well, I can't fuck that one up, can I? Because he already balls that one up already.
Okay, well, brilliant, right? Okay, well, how can you do it?
Well,
how can you do better?
Like, what he proposed was having kids start school earlier and finish at 6. No, start at 9, finish at 6.
Okay.
That's stupid.
Well, it is stupid. I would agree with him.
That is a stupid idea.
It is stupid.
Just keep school the same as it is. Don't mess around with it.
Okay.
And that. And when teachers go on strike, sack them because they're just wanting more money.
No, you can't just sack all your teachers.
Why are you going on strike?
You can't sack all your teachers. You can't, no.
We want better pensions.
Okay. So basically,
we want more money.
So basically, me and Chris have gone on strike. Yeah, and now we're
sacked. Why have you gone on strike?
Right. And now we're sacked.
Why have you gone on strike?
Because we want more money, like you said.
Yeah, because for some reason we don't believe that the money that we're being paid is enough. You know, we're being paid a very low salary for long
hours. You see, Wayne, this is your fault, you fucking cunt.
It actually has nothing to do with
Rooney at all. Wayne, it has nothing to do with
you. Nothing to do with you,
Yes, it does.
Well, no, but
would you give him £300,000 a week for kicking a football?
Well, that's not our choice. That's not the government's choice. That's
no, you would spend it on people that matter, right? Like teachers, because they're educating the people.
David, the money that we're only
just. Shut up! You're not even in this. You're just like white noise.
Yeah, but he's right. The government doesn't pay for Wayne Rooney's wage.
No. That's Manchester United who pay for his wage. That's actually nothing to do with the government spending.
Right, so I am Education Secretary.
Yes, you are.
And we, as representing all the teachers in the country, have gone on strike over pay.
Pay.
So now you have money? You have to you have to have a meeting.
You're not working longer hours because I've sacked that idea off.
Well, you
okay.
You
well, for some reason, we actually think maybe we're not going to strike over the pay, but over the fact that when we retire, our pensions aren't going to see us through.
You've already gone on strike about that, and he was so.
Well, the thing is, though, you've just met us for a meeting about it. So, you're having a meeting about our pay now.
Yeah.
Well,
you've been on strike once. Why do you want more?
You're going to have to negotiate. We may compromise with you, but you can't just go in there and say you're all.
I'll buy you a better dictionary.
Tell me
your teacher's school. You can have better books. In foreign languages.
A better dictionary. Did you say buy a better dictionary? I mean, all dictionaries are the same. They have the same words in.
All dictionaries not the same, Satch?
No.
All English
What's the difference between the Oxford
difference?
Dictionary
and,
yeah.
is
and
Penguin,
another dictionary?
Penguin different in Oxford?
Because the Swedish have just updated their dictionary.
Okay, so in terms of English dictionaries, not Swedish.
There's new words being made up though every day.
Yeah, but they're all practically the same. They are all practically the same.
Right,
and
okay,
they all
right,
update
okay,
them at
you
the
won't
same
have
time.
A dictionary then. Right, because you've already got loads from whenever. I'll get you better books so you can educate the people properly.
Okay.
You can have better training.
I actually don't think it's about the books.
Right. Okay. Well, what is it about then?
Well, it's not about the books because they.
If you said to people who were thinking more along the lines of their like pensions, and you said we're just going to give you better books,
a better
that's
book.
Almost insulting their teaching ability.
An example of a better book, okay, would be like Postman Pat and Lord of the Rings. You're going to teach Lord of the Rings to the early year threes because good luck with that.
I started reading Lord of the Rings and it just got complicated.
See, even you don't get it, so I mean, it's not going to do very good if you get them just better books.
If you write a book, it's pretty much going to get turned into a film, so you might as well just watch the film.
That is genius. That is absolute genius. And for all the authors out there, just don't bother writing books. Just wait for filmmakers to just come up with the ideas themselves.
And, I mean, the kids will be loving that, but when they get to year 11, they'll be fucked.
Don't know.
That makes no sense. Have you got any special childhood memories that things you used to do regularly or
play football,
anything else? Because we could all say that.
Watch TV.
That's basically it.
What TV did you watch?
What was your favourite kind of programme when you were growing up?
Because a lot of the programmes that we would consider absolute like classics of like children's television, I've just stopped that. People don't watch it.
But they're on when you were small, because you're saying your age.
What did you watch when you were at primary school?
Well, it's my dad's fault, really. He made me watch Thunderbirds and Captain Scarlet.
Stingray. What do you think of them?
They're brilliant.
Cause I agree. I think they are brilliant.
They are brilliant. How a puppy is all on the string, but then it'll cut in. He's got a real hand messing with a pen. Yeah.
It's true. I mean, that's genius.
It is properly good.
But you can still see the strings as well, and yet some of the model works brilliant, isn't it?
Yeah.
What do you think?
He's got a pen. He's playing with it.
I remember shows like Get Your Own Back. Do you always Get Your Own Back?
Yeah, getting gushed.
Yeah.
If you could get your own back on someone, who would it
be? Anyone in the world.
You two bastards. There you go.
Crank him up. Well,
yeah, but it's our show, so you can't get us.
No.
Yeah, I can.
Without us, you wouldn't have a show.
Yeah.
It's our show. We're making this for you, so.
Who would I get? I don't know. Who wound me up?
Lots of people wind you up. How is this happening?
The whole world seems to wind you up, so.
Sean Terry winds you up.
Yeah, because he's just a cunt, isn't he? I don't know. Who would I get my own back on?
Oh my god,
it can't.
Every day
you
basically ranting
about people for the last like half an hour and you're now struggling to find anybody you're pissed off at.
Yeah, I'll probably dunk your dead teacher.
Because we're putting on a thick table.
No, she didn't put me on the thick table. She just put me in the corner of a room. I don't know why she did it. Maybe.
But you would do that if you were the. You said before you would do that if you had a teacher. With certain people.
Yeah, with
well,
certain.
Well, that makes no sense.
No, but I didn't deserve to be there though, because I wasn't doing anything wrong. I wasn't. I might have been. I can't remember. I might have actually been pissing about. Yeah.
Did she put you in the corner of the room facing the wall?
We should do that. Sit over there. Get over there. Get your chair. Get over there now.
Yeah, with the table.
Picture
him
doing that, please.
I will do that.
Yeah, she made me go in the facing the wall, so we moved schools then.
What, you actually had to face the wall?
That's absolutely
table and everything facing the wall.
She's my hero for doing that, that's a great idea.
She's not, because she was in the school, and then she was sacked.
Well, you've been sacked three times in the last half an hour.
Yeah.
For various positions of authority.
I fucking it on completely.
Yeah.
Well, another show that me and Pickles remember is Bernard's Watch. Now, do you know what Bernard's Watch was actually about?
A guy had a watch and he stopped time so he could like rearrange things.
Yeah.
And then he started it again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a bit stupid, that, because that's just like the film Click.
Bernard's Watch came like. I'm right, yeah. It came years before, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so. Yeah. Technically, Click copied Bernard's Watch.
Yeah.
If they knew about it. I mean, they probably didn't, but.
He probably did.
You can't say that Bernard's Watch copied that when Bernard's Watch came before that. That's impossible.
And the idea has been around for years.
It's
to stop time, go back in time, go forward in time.
It's stupid.
It
is.
Well, okay. Say you had a watch right now. You can stop us moving. Stop everyone moving out there.
Yeah.
You can stop time and you can start it again. What would you use that ability for? What would you use?
Oh, this could be fucking brilliant. This.
So what would you use that for?
It would something to do with you two.
No.
What I would do.
What would be the advantage of doing anything to us two? Really?
Because it'd be funny.
Okay. What would you do to us? You can stop time, so we like freeze.
Yeah.
And then you can still do stuff, and then you start it again.
Got very inappropriate thoughts in my head. It's not right.
We can't really air this.
No, you're gonna have to edit this out. I'm sorry, this is gonna have to be very edited out.
Go on, what is it?
Right. Have you seen Pulp Fiction where the big black guy gets raped over the horse? He'll be like that.
You'd rape a big
black guy.
These two would be having gay sex.
And that's seriously the number one thing on your list to do with a watch. Soft time.
No, seriously.
The thing about all things in the world you can do, the number one thing is to do that.
Yeah. But
so you would physically strip these two down?
No, because I'll get someone else to do that.
But you're the only one who can stop time.
You're the only one who's moving time. Everyone else is still. You can't get someone else to do
this
that.
This is getting edited out.
No, this is pretty good. No, but this is. But how would you move? How? But you can't move people about.
Right, sorry, this isn't right.
Why?
Right, we should move on. Top Cat, I liked watching Top Cat.
Why do you move on?
Because it's just going to get more stupid.
No, this is good. This is good shit.
It's not good shit because it should be edited out.
Well, you shouldn't have brought it up in the first place then.
No, you shouldn't have brought it up. See,
no,
if you could stop time.
You went on to something like fucking Jimmy Savile stuff. You can't tell us to fucking not do it.
So, Sarge, do you know Bernard's watch?
Yeah.
Do you know anything about it at all?
Yeah, the watch could stop time and restart time.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. How would you use it in your life?
Anything in the world.
I wouldn't.
You wouldn't use it at all?
No.
So you wouldn't.
I'd like to fucking rob a bank.
When I'm playing football,
okay.
Right, I could stop the watch on a shoot because every time it goes wherever it wants. And I'll put the ball just as it's about to go in the net and restart it, and then I'll be able to score every goal.
That's a fair way of using it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why not?
And I'd also get my own back on traffic cops as well. Stop it when I see a policeman in the car, and then get his phone out, put it in his hand, and then start filming him as he's driving along saying, "You're nicked," if for having your phone on your ear.
Oh my god.
So first you have to get a policeman, put him in a car.
He'll be driving the car so I can stop the time.
We have to find a policeman to start with, yeah.
Well, I'll be driving around.
And then you have to balance this phone in his hand.
Yeah, that wouldn't work, would it?
But then you'd also, how would you... Right, so, okay.
Why didn't you bring this up when we were talking about getting your own back? You just said, I would like to get my own back on traffic cops. Well, do that then.
No, because I've got no beef with traffic cops. They're not doing it wrong to me.
Well, you just said you'd want to get them nicked for them.
Yeah, you said you wanted to get your own back on traffic cops.
No, I said I'd get my own back on these two.
No, but you just said traffic cops, right? Just like, do you remember that 30 seconds ago? You said...
No, because I stopped time. And this conversation didn't happen when I stopped the time on the watch.
Oh dear. This is hypothetical.
So you're saying that whilst we've been having this conversation, you would actually stop time during this conversation.
Even though we still have remembered what happened.
Sarge, we're talking, okay, we're not still.
Oh,
Jesus Christ.
Right, Bernard's watch. I don't know what it is.
It's not hard, Sarge.
Well, I don't know what I'll do with it though, because there's no point in having a watch that can stop time, because it won't happen. It can't happen. You can't have a watch that'll stop time.
It's a hypothetical situation.
It's a television show. It can't happen in real life. It actually can't happen. It's like, you know,
what's the point in having it if it can't work?
Brilliant. So that's any basis of any entertainment program. So any drama,
which
so
is
just basically tell Doctor Who, right?
Which
can't have it. Can't have it. 50 years. Oh, it's gone on 50 years, right? But apparently, you can't have Doctor Who because the whole premise hinges on something that's absolute bollocks.
So they can't let it on TV.
You're saying that's not work.
Not real.
No, but Doctor Who is an awesome TV show.
Okay, right. But you just dismissed it, saying that the initial premise is complete bollocks.
Maybe, yeah.
Goodness me. Right, well, you've just contradicted yourself about 50 million times during this programme, but next time, we're going to be discussing films.
And obviously before, we were talking about school and teachers and homework.
We actually didn't go on homework, so I didn't do any homework.
Well, that's to do with school. That's to do with
because Pro Evo 6 was awesome. You could get trimming board and twat it from the halfway line and it would go in.
Okay, so
okay, so back to the
film.
No,
what I'm
on about, mate. No, back to it, right. We're going to be discussing films, and we've got two things for you to work on.
Right, what's that?
I want you to give you to write down a list of your favourite films.
Why write them down? Because I already know them.
Okay, fine.
Well, just remember.
Just come prepared to say your favourite films and why. And also, if you had an unlimited budget.
I've got to make a film.
We want you to come up with an idea for a film. Who would who would star in the roles, and we want you to run through the story for us.
Yes.
And we would say, brilliant, make it. Or because we're the producers, you're pitching us your film idea.
We have the unlimited budget.
Oh dear God.
And you have the idea, and you've got to sell us the film. And we've got to question
you've
it.
You've got
and
to come up
the storylines, plots, twists, characters.
I'll just make it up on the spot. I don't know, I couldn't come up with it. All the good films have been done.
No, there
isn't. I'll leave everyone, the audience, right? I'll leave you to ponder that statement.
What about new films? Fucking hell, lad.
All the good films have been done, right?
There is good films that come out these days. I mean, you know films. I mean, you could name the 10 that have come out that are good, actually good, in the last year or two.
In the last year or two.
He knows more than me, not you. You don't know anything.
Okay, so if... Right, okay.
Rush, yeah.
Okay.
That was a good film.
Brilliant. Right, okay.
People
still
make good films, then.
Yes.
Right. It's like you can come up with
that one's already been made,
towards,
so I can't come up with one.
Okay, so if you said that last year, then basically you're saying Rush is going to be shit. Every Captain Phillips is going to be shit. All these films.
No, because that's based on a true story. Like I said before, books. What did I say before about books?
I don't know.
What is the point in writing a book because it's going to be made into a film anyway?
Because.
But then the film has no basis.
Because it's a true story. It was in the news. So you know about it. It's in the news. So they made a film about Captain Phillips.
Brilliant. So basically, right, Lord of the Rings.
It's a book, yeah.
Okay, 11 Oscars that won. 11 Oscars.
Yeah, because
some people
they sat through all 3.5 hours of it.
We want you to come up with an idea.
They just gave it Oscars because it was 3 hours and they're going, is it over yet? Oh, just give it an Oscar.
So this isn't hard. You need to come up with an original idea for a film.
They've all been done.
You have to do it. I'm sorry. We're going to take that answer.
You have to do it.
All the films that I would come up with have been done.
Okay, you have to move on and tell us what it is.
Even if they've been done, come up with a new way of redoing it then. You could remake an existing film.
With different plots and the Italian jobs being remade.
That's always good.
Remake that again. Well, there you go, that's one idea. You could remake it one.
Yeah.
You could remake it again. Just come up with all you want. There's an idea. You have an unlimited budget on this. You can get any cast you want.
You could literally do like the seventh Rocky film.
You could do anything you want.
Rocky fights Mike Tyson.
Gets his ear burned.
You could do anything. Okay, but you're going to have to tell us it and we're going to have to say whether we think it's a good idea, what changes you should make, or whether it's just a shit idea.
You've got to come up with a plot line.
It's going to be a shit idea because it's going to be, I've come up with it.
Well, how do you know? It may be
because
awesome.
It is.
Maybe
like, oh.
Well, how do you know? Next time we are in this room, you don't come up with an idea that then gets made into a massive film that actually wins awards and makes loads of money. And it could do.
Yeah, then Steven Spielberg going here.
But it was your idea.
It was my idea, but he will still...
Yes, but he has to watch this.
He has to watch this.
So you know, he's not going to watch. He's not going to know this.
So, the next time, folks, we're hoping that Sarge can come up with a new film idea. And apparently, you know, it's going to be shit because apparently all new films are. So, see you later. Until next time.
Is life just a game where we make up the rules while we're searching for something to say? Our fate.